Jesus Christ should bless you so much. This is Evangelize the Way. We preach Jesus Christ. God bless you so much once again. We are here to talk about Jesus as usual, that we preach Jesus as our response. God bless you. I want you to share the link with your families, your friends, your loved ones, your enemies, anyone that you can find around, your neighbors, everyone. Just try your possible best to share the link with other people so that they can also benefit from the message of the Lord Jesus Christ. I know your life will be much transformed by the message. And you are going to be like our Lord and our Master Jesus, in the name of Jesus, our Lord's name. Let's have a word of prayer before we share the word of God. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, we bless your name. We thank you, our Lord and Master Jesus, for doing marvelously and wonderfully with us. We are here, O Lord, to share your way. I pray by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit, that Heavenly Father, give us your word from your spirit. Open the eyes of our understanding that we will understand your way. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, that Heavenly Father, take away any knowledge of evil out of us. Let the fire of the Holy Spirit consume any knowledge of evil that can be found within us. Heavenly Father, and fill our life with the spirit of you, God, and the tree of life. I believe in the wonder-working power in the blood of Jesus. So I pray in the name of Jesus that let the power in the blood of Jesus work on us. Let the blood of Jesus work on us. I know our life will be much transformed by the message. We thank you, Christ Jesus, for transforming our life for us to be like our Lord and Master Jesus. We bless your name in the name of Jesus. Our Lord's name we pray. Amen. Jesus Christ should bless you once again. Today, I want us to share a message that has been titled, Be Careful of the Knowledge of Evil. Be careful of the knowledge of evil. Be careful of the knowledge of evil. I want to start the message by introducing a phrase, or let me just introduce you to something. I am here. I am in school. I may think you may also be in school, or you may also be at work. But then the kind of knowledge that we are receiving today is going to differentiate who we are going to be tomorrow. So if the knowledge I'm having right now, or the knowledge I'm receiving right now, is about being an engineer, there is no way I can receive knowledge about an engineer and arrive being a doctor. No, it doesn't work that way. So the knowledge I'm going to receive right now, I am going to be like that same knowledge in the future years, or let me say in some time to come. And also, if you are receiving knowledge about being a mechanic, definitely you shall be a mechanic in future. If the knowledge you are receiving is about how to cook well, maybe you are receiving knowledge about, graphic design, definitely you shall be a graphic designer. So any knowledge that you are receiving over a period of time, you tend to exhibit the character and the behavior of that knowledge. Yes. So I want to talk about, be careful of the knowledge of evil. Why should man be careful of the knowledge of evil? And then we shall go into the Bible, and then we shall study a few ways from scripture. I know your life will be much transformed by the message. God bless you. The message that we are going to share is from Genesis chapter 2, verse number 9. Genesis chapter 2, verse number 9. And out of the ground, the Lord God made every tree grow that is pleasant to the sight, and good for food. The tree of life was also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil was also in the garden. God has actually created a man like his own image, after his own likeness. Adam was a man that was like God. If you are saying something is like God, it means that the moment you see Adam, you see God. Adam was a reflection, or was the image. If God is standing in a mirror, what God is going to see is his image, and God is going to see Adam. So Adam was a direct reflection of the image of God. Yes, that is what I'm going to say. So when God has created this Adam that was like him, God planted a garden for him, and God placed in the garden every tree that is good for the sight and also is good for food. But within that garden, there was a tree that was carrying life. So actually, there was something that could give life in the Garden of Eden. And then there was also a tree of knowledge of good and evil. So within the garden too, there was something that was existing in the garden that was called knowledge of good and evil. I want to talk about the knowledge of evil. If we read that, I think you can read that verse. But then I want to comment something on the verse chapter 15 down to the same verse, chapter 2, verse 15. Then the Lord took the man and put him in the garden of Eden to tend and keep it. And the Lord commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. For in the day you shall eat of it, you shall surely die. So I have realized that this was what God told man. Why did God say that man is able to eat from every tree in the garden? It means that God has actually given mankind the authority to eat from the tree of life. Man is created like God. God is living eternally. God has no end. He is the Alpha and the Omega. So God is the beginning and also the end. So there is nothing like after God. There is nothing like before God. Something like that don't exist. So God is the beginning and God is the end. So man was supposed to live like God. If we have all the abilities and the qualities of God, we can be like God. And God gave us something that we can live forever and ever with it, and that was called life. God actually didn't plant man, or let me say, God didn't plant in man life. No. Nor did God give man death. But then death and then life was a choice by Adam. But then God gave mankind the opportunity, the chance of every man to choose from life. So God never restricted Adam about the tree of life, because in the 16, he said that, and the Lord God commanded the man, saying, it was a commandment that man had to obey. Of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. So it means that every tree in the garden, including the tree of life, man had the opportunity to eat from that tree, with the exception of only one thing. That is called knowledge of evil and good. Man was exempted from that tree. Let me tell you, be careful about everything that you have. Adam had everything in the whole world. Everything belongs to Adam. There was only one thing that Adam was exempted from, and that was the tree of good and evil. Still, man wanted to have that one too. Be very, very careful about the things that you have. Don't be in a hurry to make money. Don't be in a hurry. Even the first Adam had everything in the on the surface of the earth, he was not satisfied. Just be comfortable with the things you have. Just be comfortable. Praise God for the small that you have. The Bible says that we have to be content with what we have. Be very happy about the small things that you have. Don't chase after worldly things, because Adam had everything in the Garden of Eden, including everything. All the animals, all the plants, all the trees, all the lands on the surface of the earth, they were owned by Adam. He was the only man existing. But yet still, Adam fell because of only one thing. Because of only one thing, Adam fell. Be very, very careful. This was the instruction God gave mankind. And he said that the day you... He says that, for in the day that you shall eat of it, you shall surely die. Listen, in the Bible is talking about a day in the sight of God. God is talking about 1,000 years. That is the meaning of a day. I think it's in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse number 7, also Psalm 90. You can read about that. A day in the sight of man is 1,000 years in the sight of God. And 1,000 years in the sight of God is just like a day. So the God was saying that the day that man shall eat of the tree of good and evil, you shall surely die. For in the day, God didn't say at the end of the day. He says that for in the day you shall eat of it. And God was talking about 1,000 years. God made man understood that if you are supposed to eat from the tree of life, then we shall going to live our life eternally because we are free. But then the moment we eat from the tree of good and evil, our life is restricted to a day, and we are going to die within that day. This is why after the fall of Adam, we realize that in Genesis, I think chapter 6 or chapter 7, if you read Genesis from chapter 7, chapter 8, chapter 9, you are going to realize that some people had 930, 950, 800 and something, 700 and something. They were not. All of them were not up to 1,000 years. That is one day. They were not up to 1,000 years, so they all died in the day. They didn't die at the end of the day. No man is able to live up to 1,000 years. That is a day in the sight of God because of this case. Because of this case. The life of man was shortened because of the knowledge of evil. This was a warning God gave mankind. That the moment you are going to receive knowledge about evil, you are going to die within a day. Within a day. Be very, very careful about the knowledge you are receiving. And God was talking about 1,000 years. So the life of man was limited from eternity to 1,000 years. This is how come those times, Adam, Noah, those kind of people, Shem, Ham, Cain, Abel, and those kind of people, their sons, Lamech, and Seth, and then Enoch, they were able to live so much. They were able to live 900 and something, because God said they were should die during the day. This is why no man was able to live 1,000 years on the surface of the earth. Because God said that the day we shall receive knowledge about evil, we must die during that day. We must die in that day. Be very, very careful. If you don't want to end your life in hell, lake of fire, be very, very careful about the kind of knowledge you are receiving. Stop acquiring knowledge about occultism. Stop acquiring knowledge about idolism. Anything evil, stop acquiring knowledge about them. Be very, very careful about lesbianism and gayism. Stop acquiring knowledge about pornography and masturbation. Any kind of sin that you are engaging yourself in, be very, very extra careful about the knowledge you have. Because you shall surely be like that knowledge in future. Be very, very careful. Let's continue on scriptures. Genesis chapter 3. Now the serpent, Genesis chapter 3 verse 1. Now the serpent was more cunning than any of the beasts in the field which the Lord God has made. And he said to the woman, has God indeed said you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? You see, when Satan came, Satan didn't attack anything in the garden, but rather he attacked the word of God. This is what Satan needs from us. You see, listen, when Satan came, he said to the woman, has God indeed said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? So when Satan came, Satan attacked the word of God. This is how Satan attacked us. Satan is always attacking the word of God. So be very, very conscious about the word of God. Be very, very conscious about the word of God. Satan is not just after you, but then he is after the word of God that you have received. This is the aim of the devil. This is the aim of Satan. He always comes to take away the word of God that you have received away from your heart. And I think Jesus Christ gave a parable that when the word of God comes and then you don't understand, Satan comes and then takes it away from your heart. Be very, very careful. Be very, very extra careful. This was why Satan came. Satan went to Eve because of the word of God. Be very careful. Satan is coming to you not because of anything, but then because of the word of God you have. Be extra careful. Be extra careful. And the woman said to the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die. Then the serpent said to the woman, you will not die, for God knows that in the day you shall eat of it, your eyes will be open, and you shall be like God, knowing good and evil. Listen, you see, the devil is a liar. If you are not careful, you might think that Satan actually quoted what God said. No, Satan didn't quote what God said. Listen to what the devil said. He said, you shall not surely die. And that was the first lie. For God knows that in the day you shall eat of it, your eyes will be opened. Your eyes will be opened. And you shall be like God, knowing good and evil. But in Genesis chapter 2, verse number 28, God has created man like him. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 28, God has created man after his own image and after his own likeness. So man was already like God. In this quotation, man was already like God. So that was the deception that Adam gave. That was the deception the devil gave the woman. Because they were already like God. If you read the Genesis, it says that male and female God created them in the Genesis chapter 1. So man was already like God. It wasn't like we are now coming to eat the fruit for our eyes to be open so that we be like God. No. There is no darkness in God. There is no evil in God. God is a God of life. Why is it that the devil didn't talk about life, but then he attacked the evil? Because it's not that the day they shall eat of it, their life plan will be shortened. Their life plan will be shortened. So the woman saw that the tree was good for food, that it was pleasant to the eyes, and the tree desirable to make one wise. She took of it and ate. She also gave her husband, and he ate. And the eyes of both were open, and they knew that they were naked. You see, this was the problem that man faced. Have in mind, the first thing that will ever happen to you after you acquired some knowledge of evil. You see, the food that man ate of was a or was about evil, and the day that they took from it, that day they became naked. And if you become naked, you lose protection. You lose protection. So that very day, man became naked to the weapons of the devil. Two, man carried the seed of evil in them. Be very, very careful about the knowledge you are having. Stop receiving knowledge about evil things. Stop learning live evil things. Start learning about the good things that the Lord has done to send for the Son Jesus to die for you and I. This is the knowledge of good. This is the knowledge of God. This is the tree of life. Therefore, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in that Son should not perish but have everlasting life. This was the life that existed in the Garden of Eden. This is the knowledge that you must receive. You must have knowledge about the life of God. Stop receiving knowledge about evil, for you shall end in death. For you shall end in death. In the day that man received knowledge about good and evil, that day their eyes were open. In that day, their eyes were open and they became naked. They lost protection. And in that day, they died. They didn't spend more than a day and they died. And if I'm talking about a day, I'm talking about 1,000 years. They died along 1,000 years. Man, we are supposed to live everlastingly. Why is it that I always ask people, why is it that the sea is still there from the day it was created until now, but Adam has died a long time ago? Is the sea more important than you and I? The land is still there. Is the land more important than you and I? The earth has been existing from creation, but the earth is never like God, but we are like God. Why is it that we are losing our nature? It's because of this evil thing that we did. And man is always doing evil things. And let me tell you that, you see, God gave man eternal life in the Garden of Eden. The day that we received knowledge about evil, the life man was shortened in a day, 1,000 years. Let's look at something. Let me continue in the verse 17. I want to read something in the verse. I want to read something about the curse of man. Yes. I want to read about something in the curse of man in that same Genesis chapter 3. In Genesis chapter 3, verse number 11. Well, let me read from the verse 9. Then the Lord called to Adam and said to him, "Where are you?" So he said, "I heard your voice in the garden and I was afraid because I was naked and I hid myself." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree which I commanded that you should not eat?" Then the man said, "The woman whom you gave me the tree, fruit of the tree, and I ate." Listen to the reply Adam gave. "The woman you, God, you gave me. She gave me." So you see, man has not accepted his fault in the first place. When God created Adam in Genesis chapter 2, he said that man shall not, it's not good for man to be alone. It is not good for man to be alone. In other words, it is bad for man to be alone. When the serpent came in the Garden of Eden in Genesis chapter 3, where was Adam when the serpent was talking to Eve? Adam was alone, and Adam has already broken that law. The word that said that man, it is no good for man to be alone. Adam has already broken that word of God. the devil came, when the serpent came, the devil was having an interaction with the woman alone. It means that Adam was also alone somewhere in the garden. But God has said in Genesis chapter 2 that it is not good for man to be alone. So when Adam was alone, Adam has already broken that law. So Adam, instead of Adam to accept his father, Lord, I broke that law. I was alone in the garden. Adam didn't accept him too. Adam was the head of the family. Adam was the head of the family. Instead of Adam to accept his fault, he shifted the blame to Eve. And then it was a cheat. You just imagine the response that Adam gave. Can we even talk to our president like that? How much God, you mere man, you mere mortal, talking to God that, listen, the woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me the tree and I ate. This was the response. And the Lord God said to the woman, what is this that you have done? And the woman said, the serpent deceived me and I ate. Listen, the woman was also telling God, the serpent that you go, you created, deceived me and I also ate. Then God, so the Lord said to the serpent, because you have done this, I don't want to talk about this. You didn't let me talk about them. Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all the cattle and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And listen, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. Do you know that man was created from dust in Genesis chapter 2 verse 7? And God was telling the serpent he shall eat from dust. This is the curse that man received. This was the beginning of our end. You and I, we are created from dust. And God was telling the devil that you shall eat dust all the days of your life. I want to continue. I don't want to talk about these things. I want to talk about the verse 17. And to Adam he said, because you have heeded to the voice of your wife and have eaten from the tree which I commanded you, saying, you shall not eat. Curse is the ground for your sake. Curse is the ground for your sake. That was the first one. If you are talking about the ground, you are talking about the earth. And it contained dust. And God has cursed the land. Man, you shall always eat from the ground. Even in the garden, man was eating from the ground. The tree that bear that evil fruit was embedded in the ground. Do you know that every food that we have on the surface of the earth comes from the ground? Even the water is on the ground. Or let me say, the foundation, or if you go to the basis of the water, you can still find land there. And God is saying that curse is the ground because of you, Adam. You, Adam, you are also a product of the dust, and curse is the ground. And the serpent, that is the devil, is also supposed to eat from that same ground that has been cursed. So number one, you, Adam, you are a food for the devil. The ground that you, Adam, must eat from, the devil is also eating from that same ground. So there is also scarcity. This is all because of the evil things that man had knowledge of, resulted in these things. Be very, very careful about the knowledge you are receiving. Be very careful. Knowledge is so powerful. You can eat the link of fire because of the knowledge you are acquiring over some period of time. Here, man wanted to work as in Namibia anymore. Just say, here, you are Jimmy Abwa. No, because in Namibia anymore. It's because of the knowledge that people have received over some period of time, they are able to open their mouth with their 32 teeth saying there is no God. Even they themselves, they believe they are there, but they don't believe that God is there. That is how powerful knowledge is. How powerful evil is. If you receive knowledge of evil over some period of time, you even try not to recognize that there is God. You see, God has cursed man. He said that curse is the ground for you, your sake. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Just as God said to the serpent, that you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And man is also supposed to eat from that same ground. In toil all the days of the devil, their God didn't say that they shall toil. He said that they shall just eat all the days of their life. But man, you shall toil on that ground that has been cursed. That is, the devil is eating from, you must toil all the days of your life.
Because man has received knowledge about evil. Be very, very careful with the knowledge that you are receiving. Be very, very careful with the knowledge you are receiving. Both tongues and pestles shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the herb of the field. Listen. Just imagine tongues. Be very careful. Be very careful. Try your possible best to declare yourself safe from the knowledge of evil. Try from today to acquire knowledge about good things. Search about good things. Search about Jesus. Search about life. Man has rejected the tree of life from the Garden of Eden until now, and we are still perishing. Try to seek about the knowledge of about life. Try to search for life. You shall live by life. You shall die by evil. You shall live by life and you shall die by evil. In the sweat of your face, you shall eat bread till you return to the ground. Listen, till you. So even after all this, you must go back to the ground that the devil must eat from. Be very careful. Be very careful about knowledge of evil. Be very careful. Make sure you train your mind about good things. Stop thinking about evil things. There are so many people that are thinking about death too much. I don't understand why you should think about death whilst there is more to enjoy about life. Stop thinking about the devil. Forget about witches and wizards. Think about Jesus. 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 Let's go to Genesis chapter 4, verse 1. Now Adam knew his wife, and she conceived and bore Cain, and said, I have acquired a man from the Lord. Listen. I have acquired a man from the Lord. And do you remember in Genesis chapter 3, God cursed man. God cursed man in Genesis chapter 3. And Eve was saying that I have acquired a man from the Lord. That was the beginning of the end of Cain. This was where the curse of Cain began. Because Cain was a man and man has been cursed. That man shall toil from the ground. Man shall eat from the sweat from their face. Man shall suffer. This was the end of Cain. Be very, very careful about the things you say. They are very, very powerful. This was the beginning of the end of Cain. Cain wasn't Cain's fault. It was because of the word that the mother said. It was because of the word that the mother said. And mother said this out of pain. And the mother said that, oh, I have acquired a man from the Lord. And then she bore, let me go to, and she bore again and named that child Abel. Now Abel was a keeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground. You see? Abel was not a tiller of the ground, because I'm going to read Abel's own. Abel was a keeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground, because when Cain was born, the mother said that I have acquired a man from the Lord. A man has been cursed. And the land has also been cursed because of man. So no wonder Cain became a tiller of the ground. All these things happened because man has acquired knowledge about evil. And we must die. The suffering of Cain was because he was called a man. And two, he became a tiller of the ground because he was a man. Be very, very careful about the knowledge you have. Clear your mind about evil things. Clear your mind about demonic things. Stop learning demonology. You shall not gain anything from it. Start learning about how to cast demons. Start learning about how to raise the dead. Start learning about how to heal the sick. Start learning about how to deal with the demonic spirit. Than learning demon. What shall you gain if you learn witchcraft? Start learning about how to overcome them. Start learning about the powers and the authority of our Lord Jesus Christ to overcome these things. Than to learn this witchcraft and this occultism and Freemason and other things. You shall not benefit anything from them. You shall rather be like them. Learn good things. Learn about life. Learn about God. Learn about God. Learn about Jesus. Learn about Jesus. Let's go to Genesis chapter 5. And let's see something. This is the genealogy genealogy. Okay. I think I'm speaking very fast. This is the book of the genealogy of Adam. In the day that God created man, he made him in the likeness of God. So meaning now, Adam has been positioned in the likeness of God, not in the curse. In the likeness of God, he created them male and female and blessed them and called them mankind in the day they were created. And Adam lived 130 years and begot a son in his own likeness. After his image, listen, begot a son in his own likeness after his image and named him Seth. So the reason Seth became Seth was because he was created, he was born to be like the image of Adam, and Adam was the image of God. So this was why Adam, Seth was blessed. This was why Seth was blessed, because he was like Adam, and Adam was like God. Seth didn't become a man. No, he became like Adam after his image, that is after God. So Seth was already blessed. Seth was already blessed. So Seth was a son of God. Let's look at something. In Genesis, Luke chapter 3, verse number 38, was talking about the genealogy of Jesus Christ. And if you go to the 38, he says that, and the son of Enoch, and the son of Seth, the son of Adam, the son of God. So Adam was the son of God, and the Seth was the son of Adam. So Adam, Seth was the grandson of God. Do you get the quotation? So if you are talking about, I'm going to arrive something in, I'm going to explain something in Genesis chapter 6. So I want to establish the fact that Adam was the son of God. Seth was also the grandson of God. In other words, Seth was also the son of God. But then Cain wasn't the son of God, because Cain was a man under curse. He was a man. But then Seth was a son of God. I hope you understand. If you check the Genesis chapter 4, when Cain was going, he said that I have acquired a man from the Lord. This time I have acquired a son of God. He said I have acquired a man from God. You have a difference between a man of God and a man from God. It's not the same. And a son of God is different from a man acquired from the Lord. So Cain's problem was that he was a man from God. But then Seth was a son of God, because he was born to be like Adam, and Adam was like God. He was born after the image of Adam, and the image of Adam was the image of God. Let's go to Genesis chapter 6. Now it came to pass, when man began to multiply on the face of the earth, daughters were born to them. You see, when men begin to multiply on the face of the earth, was talking about the descendants of Cain, because Cain was a man. So there were so many men that were being born by Cain, and they begin to multiply on the face of the earth, and they born daughters to them. So these daughters are rather daughters of men. They are the daughters of Cain. Daughters were born to them, that the sons of God saw the daughters of men. So if you see the sons of God here, was talking about the descendant of Seth, because Seth was the son of God. So he was talking about the descendant of Seth. So Seth was a son of God, and then Cain was the daughter. So the daughters of Cain and the sons of God was talking about the descendant of Seth. He said that the sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were beautiful, and they took wives for themselves of whom they chose. They chose, not God chose. So God was very angry with the decision that the descendants of Seth took, because they were the sons of God. Instead of them to marry the daughters of God, they didn't marry daughters of God, but rather they went to marry the daughters of men. That was the descendants of Cain. And Cain has already been cursed. If you're a Christian, be very, very careful about your marriage. Don't marry outside Christianity. Don't think that you can change the person Hey, you can't change yourself. It was God that changed you. How can you change someone? Don't marry wrongly. If you're a Christian, don't marry a Muslim. Don't marry them. Don't think that if you marry them, they will change. They won't change. The thing must be very careful if you're a Christian. If you're attending Pentecost, Methodist, and Baptist, don't marry a Muslim. Don't. God will get angry at you. That lesson. And the Lord said, my spirit will not stay with man forever, for he is indeed flesh. Yet his days shall be 120 years. You see, there is another thing happening here. Because of knowledge of evil, the years shall be 120 years. God said that his spirit shall not be with man. God got angry because the sons of God, as they are marrying the daughters of men. The Christians are marrying the non-Christians. The believers of Jesus Christ are marrying the non-believers. You are in church and you are dating worldly people. You still call yourself a Christian. God will get angry at you. He's going to shorten your life. He's going to shorten your life. Do you know Cain was born out of the knowledge of evil? But Seth was a son of God. But then he also went and married the people that had knowledge of evil. So there was actually a crossbreed. God got angry. Let's read something in the verse 5. In the verse 5. Then the Lord saw that the wickedness of men was great in the earth. Listen. The wickedness of men was great in the earth. Man has increased. And instead of the daughters of God to exhibit good things, because the daughters of men also carried the knowledge of evil, they got married to the sons of men, and they defied the sons of God too. So both the sons of God carried the knowledge of evil, and the daughters of men were also carrying the knowledge of evil. And the Lord saw the weakness of men on the surface of the earth had increased, and that every intent of the thoughts of the heart was only evil continually. And the Lord was sorry that he made man on the earth, and he was grieved in his heart. This is what evil idea can do. Be very careful about the kind of ideas you have. And you know the most dangerous aspect? After they have acquired this knowledge of evil, immediately they get an encounter with the sons of God. They defy the sons of God too. So they spread this evil idea, and the life of man was shortened to 120 years. From 1,000 years to 120, because man has acquired knowledge about evil. Be very careful. What evil can do to you, you don't know. This was the beginning of the end of man. From eternal life to 1,000 years. And even that 1,000 years, you will not get that 1,000 years. From that time to 120 years, because the thought of man was only evil. We shall get 120 years. Be very careful as a Christian. If you have not changed your life, come to Jesus. He's the only one that can give you life. Muhammad cannot give you life. He himself, he don't have life. How can he give life? Why do you believe someone that don't have life? Jesus says that if you die, I can bring you back to life. Muhammad is dead and he's still buried. Jesus has been raised from death. Why don't you worship Jesus that was raised from the dead? And believe in him that even if you die, he shall raise you from the dead. And believing in someone that died and never raised. He is still buried. Today he is still there. But Jesus, there is only one tomb that is empty. That is the tomb of Jesus. Come to Jesus and be saved. God bless you so much. If you want to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, just repeat these words after me, and I know your life will be much blessed. Yeah, I know your life will be much blessed. Say, Lord Jesus, I know I have committed so many evils because I carry so many knowledge about evil. But I know you are the Savior of the evil ones. I know you are the Savior of mankind. I know you are the Savior of sinners. I have come as I am, believing in the salvation of you, Lord Jesus. I know you died, and 3 days you were raised. I believe in your salvation, and I believe in your death and your resurrection. I believe you, Lord Jesus. From today, I have acknowledged you, Lord Jesus, as my only Lord and my only Savior. I've come to you. Save me from the powers of darkness. I believe you. I have turned my ways from the devil. I have repented. From today onwards, I am going to live my life like the tree of life. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for your salvation in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I am praying for you. If you are sick, headache, stomach pains, any kind of disease, chronic, hepatitis, jaundice, kidney, liver, you are suffering from mental problems, any kind of disease, I am praying for you in the name of Jesus Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit will locate you where you are and heal you now in the name of Jesus. Spirit of God, I pray blessing your name for giving us so much knowledge about your way. And from today onwards, I know you have delivered us from the knowledge of evil, and you have set us, Heavenly Father, in the knowledge of life in the name of Jesus. I pray by the wonder-working power in the mighty name of Jesus that, oh Lord, have mercy on us, Heavenly Father, and secure us in your grace, secure us in your life. I also pray in the name of Jesus that, Heavenly Father, let your Holy Spirit baptize us in the mighty name of Jesus. I also pray by the wonder-working power in the mighty name of Jesus that save us by your mighty power and save us by your authority of the Lord Jesus. I pray for anyone that has blessed us, Heavenly Father, sharing the things that they have with us. Bless them as well in the name of Jesus. I pray for my brother Sammy, Heavenly Father, that bless him so much. For this is possible because through him, Heavenly Father, you provided this. And we are here sharing your way. Bless him so much. I also pray for anyone that is sick. I pray by your mighty power in the name of Jesus that, oh Lord, bless anyone, Heavenly Father, and heal anyone of any disease in the mighty name of Jesus. Is there anyone suffering from any sickness? Let the blood of Jesus heal them. By your stripes, Heavenly Father, we are healed. I pray over any darkness that let the light of Christ shine in them. I pray over any glory that has been veiled, that their glory is unveiled in the name of Jesus. I pray and thank you, Lord, for your provision in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Jesus Christ should bless you. Evangelize the word. Preach Jesus Christ. Be empowered for action. God bless you.